and I got this guy.
Thank you. Appreciate the backup.
Let's get this health spot on here. Take it, take it.
Yeah.
Now retreat, man.
I'm trying to deal with this, dude over there. Kill him. Retreat.
You got him?
Yeah, I am gonna heal. Just give me a hot minute.
Let me just cover you until you get your health.
When I play a VR game, I always ask myself, does it feel real? Iron Rebellion is a VR mech game and I'm here to find out, do I really feel like I'm piloting a powerful mech? Are the environments immersive, the controls intuitive and smooth, and of course, is it fun? More important, how long does it stay fun? Iron Rebellion features 8 distinct mech classes, a variety of weapons, and a 3 PvP game modes, which I will cover later in details. The game has been in development for nearly 8 years, with the developer constantly releasing updates. It runs smooth and it looks great, so the environments can feel a bit plain. Right now, I'm playing the Tormentis mode, a 4 vs 4 match, where NPC mechs can fill in for player if needed. Despite the 8 mech classes, there are generally 3 categories: heavy mechs with slow movements but usually powerful long range weapon. You can use any weapon or any mech, but that's how usually players use them. They have higher HP, like 6 systems of HP. There is also the light mechs, which are fast and agile, but they have lower health. They have some special abilities, like they can actually hide. They have much more less defense also. And then there is the medium mechs, which are striking balance between both of these 2 classes. Battles in Iron Rebellion are chaotic and intense and fun. As you can see, hits can come from any direction and from all over the directions. In this case, best to retreat, take cover and wait for backup. The combat is smooth with no noticeable frame rate drops, making the action very fun to me actually. The sound effects are also good, you can feel the bullets hitting you, and while the game is easy to jump in, it's really hard to master. One thing I want to mention is the cockpit. It's really stunning with full details. The attention to details is staggering in Iron Rebellion. Tons of interesting and useful screens, a big wide field of view, lighting effects as soon as you log in. Turning on the mechs by clicking these buttons feel so natural and powerful, like turning on a car with 1000 horsepower.
I'm killing him. He doesn't want to die actually. I killed him. My first kill.
If you are starting new, I would recommend a medium mech and the Spitfire weapon, but I would also recommend to try all of the mechs. You die fast in the start of the game until you learn it, so it's good time to try all of the mechs. Don't just get stuck to one that you like for now. If you get hit in the game, you can repair. When you just click on the repairing system and select which system you want to repair, and then a very cool drones will fly around you and repair you when you are moving. It's an amazing experience and never gets old because you'll always get hit. The second move in the game is Conquest, where players get divided to 2 teams and there are 3 zones, and if a team stay in any zone and kill all the enemies in this zone, then they can conquer it slowly and turn into their color standard, you know, conquer, you know, play game approach. But it's a very strategic mode than the second mode, and make you think more about just killing everyone. But you are good in killing players, you will win anyway. The graphics resolution is good, with many options that can go all the way to ultra, and it looks cool. The mechs, the weapons, the cockpit, the shadows. All looks so cool, all detailed with very far field of view. I can see mechs even if they feel hundreds of meters away in battle. Iron Rebellion is designed for PvP. So if you have a regular group of friends and want to feel like Colonel Miles in Avatar, slashing and killing enemies, then this game is definitely for you. And even if you don't have many online friends, I ran a test in the last few weeks. So I logged in randomly in different times and I always find at least one game going on. So Even now, after almost 4 hours, I still enjoy the game. But to be honest, I would still rank it second place thought for the best VR mech after Vox Machine, just because Vox Machine have a PvE mode and have much more unique PvP modes with like sandstorms and stuff like that, slightly better music. But to be honest, also Iron Appeal runs much more smoother than Vox Machine. Now, if the developer can keep pumping new mods and new maps and support the game and the community stay active, then this game is worth its price. I think it's now in early access. I would expect its price to go higher after being fully released. It's currently available in Steam and on Quest 3 for around $15. Unfortunately, there is no plans for a PSVR 2, which I would think is a big missed opportunity, as PSVR 2 community have no single VR mech game as of now. This wraps up my review of Iron Rebellion. If you are into VR, sci-fi and space games, be sure to check out my It's Space playlist, where you find reviews, live streams and gameplay for hundreds of VR space titles. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Yes, the subscribe button is glowing right now, so go ahead and click it. And don't forget to ring the bell to get notified when I release a new video. Let me know in the comments below what you think of Iron Rebellion. Is it better than Vox Machine for you? And if you are a PSVR 2 user, would you like to see this game on the PS Store? So until next time, keep exploring space in VR, VR space lovers.